I guess I'm going to take another 3 filaments right now.
During my last video for the wireless popcorn maker, I used quite a lot of filaments. Also, unfortunately, one of my prints failed during one of the prints, and I lost quite a lot there as well. Usually 3D filaments are one of the biggest expenses that I have to pay for my projects. That's why I was searching ways to create free filament from plastics, because I was putting quite some plastic to the garbage bin every year as form of packaging. Regular 3D filament is made out of plastic pellets. They melt down the plastic pellets using extruder machines. Then they roll the filaments on spools. They are quite big and also quite expensive, so not that maker friendly. There are also DIY versions, of course, but to me they seemed quite complex and they do not look like cheap to build, of course. Also, if you include complexity to your projects, you always increase your chances of failure. I want something simpler, like a weekend project. There are cheap 3D printer spare parts available online already. I will use a thermistor, which is used in some 3D printers. It is 100K ohm and TC3950. For a smooth filament shape, I will use a 3D printer nozzle and also an aluminum hot end block. And again, for melting the plastic, 12-24V heating elements. All of them will cost you around $10. I will share the links down below. Most of the 3D printers have around 1.75mm thickness. To be able to match that, I increased the size of the hole on the nozzle with a driller. I tapered down other side of the block with a bigger drilling bit. After that, I connected the thermistor and the heating elements to their place with the screws which came with the aluminum block. I used the scrap wood as a mounting block and drilled 1cm diameter hole on it. To mount all pieces, I installed a metal piece on the wood and screwed them tight. I realized the wood was a little long. Because of that, I marked the wood to the correct size with a marker. After that, I cut the wood with a saw. To make a filament which have a consistent thickness, you need a constant material flow. To make a simple bottle cutter, I have marked 3 points on a scrap plywood. Then I truly drilled holes on the marked points. Those 2 points are simple spacers. I secured them with washers and screws. Also, I used the scalpel blade as the cutter. This long piece is a metal stud bolt and I secured it with 2 nuts to the plywood. The first step to prepare a PET bottle is to clean inside. For color bottles, you can just use water. But if you would like to use an oil bottle, you need to clean it with soap. Then of course you need to cut the label out of the bottle. I filled some isopropyl alcohol to create some pressure from the inside of the bottle. And I tightened up the cap real nice. The bottle is going to be hot, so I used an oil glove to protect my hands. However, I should warn you, putting a bottle which has alcohol in it on a rolling stove is not the smartest idea ever. If the bottle has a puncture or if the cap manages to get opened because of the pressure, you will be in a real trouble, and the trouble will be double if it catches fire. So don't do what I do, instead just use water. It will just take a little longer. I simply turn the bottle slowly and time to time I give it a gentle shake to let the liquid move inside of the bottle. Therefore it will not melt and all the molding shapes slowly disappear, and it will have an even thickness. It is important to have a uniform thickness across the bottle to make a quality filament. When you are done, you can clean the remaining label glue on the bottle. When the bottle is heated up, it is very easy to remove the glue. If you decide to ignore my warnings and still use alcohol for this step, At least don't forget to turn off the stove when you are about to open the bottle cap. Because when you open the bottle, it will release pressurized alcohol steam and it catches fire immediately. So be safe. First, I cut the bottom part of the bottle with a knife. And I dried inside of the bottle with a towel. Then with a scissor, I cut the guide on the bottle. I put the bottle on the cutting ring and pull the guide. You need 5mm spacer for the cola bottles and 7mm spacer for the mineral water bottles. Because cola bottles generally are thicker than the water bottles. I have included printable spacer models down in the description, if you need them of course. I designed the prototype with an Arduino Uno, and this is the block diagram. I have used a standard LCD to see the temperature levels, and two buttons to adjust the temperature levels. You are gonna need to use a MOSFET to drive the heating element. I have used a cheap n-channel MOSFET. I recommend to cut beginning of the straps first to inside of the nozzle before starting the filament maker. After the set temperature level is reached, I pulled entire strap from the bottle manually. From a standard mineral water bottle, you would get around 20 grams of material. From a cola bottle, you can get around 30, and from a 5 liter oil bottle, you would get around 50 grams of material. After getting my manually made fresh filament, it was time to print something. However, it does not take a long to realize filament from just one bottle is not really enough for something useful. 3D printer uses dull just in an hour. I tried many methods and ways on the test strips to connect them together. But only this method has worked. I made a few holes on one of the strips and cut the other one and cast them one in another. I recommend you not to make more than 3 holes. If you do so, sometimes the strip just breaks off. It will look a little weird outside, but printer will not cause any problems. It will work as usual. Then I did the same steps with the old PET bottles that I got and connected them together. I was able to get a half spool of filaments with the bottles that I kept, just for this project. I moved the spool holder a little bit to the right to create a little bit space for the filament maker. I strapped the filament maker on the top of the 3D printer. My idea is to let the 3D printer to pull the filaments itself and not use any extra hardware. So I will be unable to print PET bottles right away without waiting. After putting the spool to its place, I first guided the strap to the filament maker. Then I pulled enough filament by hand to reach the filament feeder of the 3D printer. I cut the first bit of the filament to put inside of the tube easier. Then the rest is the same. My printer settings are almost the same as PETG filament printing. Only differences are, I increased the temperature to 270 degrees Celsius and I also increased the feeding rate to 30%. And the printing starts. It pulls up the strips on its own and because of the temperature levels on the filament maker, form of the strip changed to filament shape that 3D printer can print. This is the finished results from a quick print. One strange thing that occurred during the print is, the print turns out white, because PET has a semi-crystallized molecule shape, which means because of the temperature changes on the material, it is fully crystallized. And that's the reason why it became white. I actually like this color more than the transparent one. I wanted to make my setup permanent. I designed and printed a suitable case for the electronics and printed that out. And to make electronics more compact, I uploaded the same code to Arduino Nano and soldered all of the components. If you decide to do this project as I do, you won't need to pay anything for filaments for the rest of your life. Just don't throw away any PET bottles. Instead, just make strips out of them and spool them away. And use them when you need them. See you next time.